Hi Leo, and welcome to my channel. This reading is torn between two lovers or between two lovers. This is for you, Leo, if you are between two lovers, you don't know which one to choose. Or for you as well, cross watcher, if you are stuck with Leo in a third party situation. If you're new to my channel, please subscribe, hit the notification button so you don't miss a video, because I'm uploading new videos every day and I'm do different readings as well for single couples, all star signs. So that one is for Leo, between two lovers or torn between two lovers. All right, let's start. So this one will be lover number one, and what they represent in your life. This is lover number two, and what they represent in your life. This is what you represent in lover number one is life, and this is what you represent in lover number two life. This is what will you get out from the relationship with lover number one. What will you get out from the relationship with lover number two? What is the problem might arise in a relationship with lover number one? The problem might arise in the relationship with lover number two. What is the advice or the most possible outcome in the future with lover number one? The advice or the what will come in the future? What is the future with the lover number two? This is your energy as well, Leo. That's what's inside you. You are the tower. So this is means that you going through something massive in your life at the moment. It's a massive energy. Like you are upset, or it's not upset. It's just like it's real depression, or someone who's feeling that really angry towards something, or there's a lot going on in your life at the moment, Leo. So let's start and see what's going on here. Yeah, look. The card under the tower is juggling too. That's interesting. So you are juggling too. Maybe that's why you're feeling that tower. You're really torn between these two. Really torn. So let's, I will flip all the cards and we'll start the reading straight away. Okay, so just let me have a just general look on all the cards and then we start straight away. Okay, so what is lover number one represent in your life? You feel that lover number one is too much load, or the relationship with them make you carry a heavy load, heavy responsibility. For some of you, it could be too much responsibility toward lover number one, or put a lot of responsibility on your back. It could be as well lots of troubles happening between you and lover number one. Maybe too much burden between you and lover number one. Like maybe something hurted you with lover number one and you're trying to clear that because you still feel that memory is too much on your back, Leo. So this is what lover number one represents in your life at the moment. It's too much burden, too much responsibility, too much load. It's just something too much for you. What you represent in their life? You represent in their life or see you as someone who is cut off their emotion from the situation. Like you don't think about them emotionally anymore. That's how they think or how they feel about you, who you are in their life. Someone who is cold, detached. What is you can like what will you get from relationship in lover number one? It looks here that you will get from them love. And you will open your heart for love, even though I can see here that you feel it's too much burden, too much load for you. Maybe this person loves you, but just you are trapped, maybe because the relationship was lover number two. So we will see. So let's split the situation between them both first. So what lover number one represent for you? Too much load, too much responsibility. What lover two, number two, represent in your life? Trapped. You feel trapped with lover number two. You feel you are a victim, or is it lover number two victimized you? So here you feel with two is that you are a victim, you trapped. With number one, you feel too much burden, too much responsibility. Who you are for lover number two, they see you as someone who detached emotionally, someone who cut off their emotion from their heart, like their heart from their mind, from the whole situation. But in the same time, they see you as someone who is fair, like you didn't do something really wrong for them. What will you get from lover number one relationship is love, opening your heart for love. What would you get? What will you get? Let's see first who you are for lover number two. Who are you represent for them? You represent for them the serious offers, or you someone who makes them stable. Looks like that you are contribute somehow with lover number two, or you both trapped in something financially. Maybe you together, and it could be as well for lover number two, this card, it could represent as well you are in court together. Like for some of you, maybe you are together in court regarding money. That could be. So you represent for them the financial stability or a partner regarding money. Like there is something in money you share them in, or a committed relationship. Might be you've been in marriage already, or you've been together for a long time, so a serious commitment. So this is how you represent in their life. What will you get from relationship with one is the love, the cup of love, the opening your heart again to love, open and like take and receive love. What will you get from lover number two? Could be financial stability, because this is the abundance, and it looks here that you have, it has something to do with money between both of you, or offer. It could be a business offer, or maybe you, because you feel trapped, so maybe this person, lover number two, is offering you more financial stability, like offer you money, or offering you a business offer, a possibility for business, a job, like it's a good offer. So, but and maybe that's why it make you feel trapped. But what you will you get from them is the abundance, like feeling secure, feeling having everything. Maybe this person already rich, could be, or have the possibility that you could both. Like maybe you both have good talent, can work out the money to a good business. But this card, this is for some of you. This card as well could represent that you will get from lover number two the independency and being self-contained. This is could be related to the abundance he will give you. You may be single, like maybe at the end of the day you will get out from relationship number two and you will be you choose to be single. Because if it is for some of you, if this is a court matter, that's mean might be some of you are going through like divorce at the moment, for some of you, Leo, and lover number two is trying to get money, maybe money from you, maybe money they deserve, could be, and you will be single again because you're doing a divorce, for some of you. That's why you feel that the relationship with lover number one is too much burden, because you love them as well, and they probably will keep telling you when you're gonna get rid of that, when will you finalize that, because you both waiting to have that love. This is for some of you. So for some of you, could get the abundance, happy regarding money, stability, having everything. Or for some of you, it could be being alone or single after you have that court matter and being single. All right. So what will you, the problem might arise with relationship with number one is the justice. Justice here, that means that you might, you or them or both of you, not feel the equality. You don't feel that you take, you or them, take exactly what you deserve. This is for some of you. For other of you, maybe this partner, like lover number one, is feeling overwhelmed of what's going on, and they will get back to you. This is could happen as well. Put that in your mind. that this lover, who lover number one, because they think they love you so much. That's why they like put a lot of load on your shoulder, and they do feel that you cut off your emotion from them. Maybe don't talk to them. When the problem arises, is they might get back to you like kind of revenge. It's not in bad way, but it will hurt you because they feel that you detached it. So it could be because this is a problem. So it won't be equality. No, it will be even real justice. They will get back to you of what you have done to them. The hurt they feel, it doesn't have to be that you have done something wrong. And for some of you, it could be just not being equal. Like you or them will not feel that this relationship is fair enough for you. Like you will feel injustice, like you give too much or they give too much, or always it's on off. This is the kind of thing you might feel, and you might feel this is a problem for you. What's the problem might arise with relationship in lover number two? It's a third party situation. It could be lover number two is offering you financial stability, abundance, independency, self-contained, all this stuff, but they might not be honest with you regarding who they are meeting or who they are seeing. And that's how you feel, because that's why that you feel like you are trapped, you are victim. Maybe you figured out later on, or you found out that they are in third party situation. Maybe you've been already with lover number one and it was great love, and then you detached your emotion and you left them, and you found lover number two who did give you a lot of stuff, like give you that best offer, and maybe they share you the money and they give you that abundance, money, stability, everything. And then you figured out that they are in third party situation as well, and they not as honest as you did think, and you felt that you are trapped and victim. Maybe this is could be for some of you. All right, what will be the advice or the most possible outcome for relationship in lover number one and lover number? That's why you scared that when you come back again to lover number one, they will get back to you. Get even and will let you feel that it was injustice, or you feel that you were injustice toward lover number one when you knew lover number two and you didn't, you detached your emotion and you didn't get that love. But it looks like you were getting that love from lover number one. So what is the most possible outcome or the advice related to lover number one is being clever, okay? Try to show how good you are, how much did you change, because you do feel that it's too much for you. Maybe you want to get back to them, to lover number one, and you're just scared because what you have done. For some of you, you feel like you did too much, and you feel the burden, you feel the load of how much you were injustice to them. You feel like down, and I feel so because you are now the tower. So I think he goes through something massive, because now you feel trapped, victim. You feel the load, you blaming yourself that you have played too. And see what is the card under this one is heartache. Under it is the betrayal. So you really go through something massive at the moment. Now you are in between them, but not happy between them. You are not torn, actually. You are thinking, for some of you, really, like, you thinking, what I have done? I've been with lover number two, and they are in a third party situation. They not honest to me. I left, or I was with lover number one. Maybe you didn't leave lover number one. Maybe you're still with them as well, and they don't know much about lover number two. It could be. But you feel the injustice. You feel how much you did hurt them for lover number one, because you have got a lot of love from them. But looks like they at least feel that you detached it, if you don't already know about this relationship. So if you thinking, it's just a suggestion. I'm not saying go back to lover number one or leave lover number two or anything. It's just I'm saying if you think that you have done bad to lover number one And what happened to you with lover number two? You're happy off and you want to leave and go back to lover number one. You need to be clever. Know how to make your way again to lover number one, because you might really face your injustice, what you have done, might be. So in this case, you need to show them how good you are now, how clever you are now, how good will you be to this situation. It will need you how to be like passionate enough towards this situation, so you can convince them that situation changes, I'm back, I'm fine, things will get better. Show up, like show to them how much you can do really for them and for this relationship. What is the advice for lover number two? This is advising you here is to go find enough information toward lover number two, because maybe you victimizing yourself, because this card can be you are a victim or you victimizing yourself and you think that, and that's not true, might be. So you need to go dig deep and find enough information, enough knowledge about what's going on. Get the true information about that third party situation. Is it true or might be is not true and you just imagining it could be. So this is just asking you to get the mental clarity and go get the right message. And as well is asking you to go talk to them, communicate with them and find a deal. Because it looks like you have together, for some of you, like something you are sharing, money or you've been together in a life, a business, something serious. And this is for some of you could represent as well a court, trapped with them in a legal matter. So in this case, for these people who are trapped in money or business or a legal matter and they about to get single or they want to get single, you need to communicate with this partner and try to find a way how to settle this situation down. All right, so this is all about lover number one, lover number two, Leo. All what's concerning me at the moment is what are you going through inside? It's just massive. You are really, really torn. Like you feel really unhappy. You have that heartache, the betrayal. And I think that you feel more toward lover number two. Maybe you feel that they betray you, could be. And maybe you feel as well you have betrayed lover number one or both. Depends on what was the real story. So just to put that quickly together, for lover number one, it could be any sign actually. I can see all the signs here in both sides. So it could be any sign. I won't say which sign. So just the main thing here, you feel really the load, the burden. You could get again love from lover number one. There would be injustice from you or maybe from them regarding that they might get back to you. If you want to be with them, you will need to work your way out with them and like use all your talents how to fix the situation with them. For lover number two, you feel trapped with them, you feel victim, you feel there is a problem. You don't know how, maybe some of you will be already in court. They feel that they worry about the money at the moment and they try to fix themselves because you, who you are for them. Maybe you are, as I said, in business together, or if they get divorced, they thinking about the money because you were the stability, might be. You will get from them independence. Being single, if you searching for a court order, you will get abundance money stuff if you've been together regarding money. You think that there could be a third party situation or they did cheat on you for lover number two, because that's the problem. Might be the problem could be as well that you didn't get enough happiness with them, or they didn't give you enough happiness. This is could be if it's not a third party. For them, you need to find the mental clarity. You need to sit and think, get the right information as well regarding all of this. What all you think is you like? Are you really a victim? They really victimized you? Are you really trapped? To communicate with them as well. If you are about to finalize a money situation, talk to them, find a middle ground between both of you before you take any decision, and in the same time to for your own peace of mind. I will give you cards for advice, because you look like here you are really in a harsh situation, Leo. Uh, This is Michelangelo prayer. Positive thoughts create positive results. My prayer, divine love and wisdom, I call upon you now. I know that my mind and emotions are internally, eternally, and continuously connected to you. I ask my higher self to be aware and conscious of the love and light that is within every person and situation. All right, so I give you one card from the angel answer. And this is said no. Let me read it for you because we have to know here in this book. Okay. This is said, the answer to your question is no. You may gather additional information by asking another question surrounding this issue and drawing another card. All right, so we will ask what's going on with Leo, what that no is meaning, and what's the information they should find more to find the peace regarding this situation. It said in the near future. So the situation will be solved in the near future. You just need to gather more information. All right, all the best, Leo, and I hope that did help you regarding the situation between the two lovers or two people you are torn. For Cross Watcher as well, all the best. Thank you for watching, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, subscribe, hit the notification button, because I'm uploading new videos every day and I'm doing different readings for all star signs. All the best, and thanks for watching. See you next time.